Okay, let's try this now. Thread is a wonderful, wonderful thing. It can be really aggravating to work with. Okay, I've got the pulley pulled back here. I've got it slipped around one of the edges. Okay, now, when I release the system, let's see what happens. In its aggravating fashion, it collapsed. This will happen. You have to try to get the system as stable as possible. Before you attempt to start, let's try again. Okay, now we see that due to the low friction, the thing takes a long time to get back to its, well, to stop. And now we can line up again and mark the position. Now, I didn't actually count the half rotations of the system, but had I done so, these marks on the paper would indicate very clearly how far the system rotated. The other thing I need to observe is where the string slips off. So if we reset the system, slip the thread on. It is important to make sure there's not a burr or something on the end of the metal here, so that the position at which the thread slips off doesn't change from time to time. Now there is where it slipped off. Somehow we've managed to get a little bit unstable. And of course we want to keep the conditions as consistent as possible when we do this experiment. So now I can mark the position where it slips off. Mark this, the off position. Should have marked the stop. And now we have a piece of paper where we can clearly see what the angles are. Now there's nothing in the middle because I had this plastic support in the middle. Because this is a piece of styrofoam and the plastic support just kind of reinforced the styrofoam to make it a little stronger. If you're doing this in a wood surface, that disc is unnecessary. I could complete these lines, and had I counted the revolutions carefully, this figure would allow me to determine the angular position through what angle we moved between the initial, which is here, where the pendulum slipped off here, and where the system stopped. Now I also need to know how far it was from the equilibrium position of the washer over to the initial position of the system. And the way you put that together, well, you're going to have to follow some instructions, but that's the setup. Okay, so you're going to get something like this. And you're going to have the length of the pendulum, the distance from the pendulum's equilibrium position, to the position of the pendulum, where the string was attached, and also the distance to where the string slipped off.